the Railroad Hour. And here comes the summer show train. Association of American Railroads, the same railroads that bring you most of the food you eat, the clothes you wear, the fuel you burn, and all the other things you use in your daily life, brings you the Railroad Summer Show Train, starring Gordon McRae and featuring Lucille Norman, with the music of Carmen Dragon and the orchestra, script by Gene Holloway, and the choir under the direction of Norman Lubloff. And now here is our star, Gordon McRae.
Thank you, Marvin Miller, and good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Well, tonight we're going to ride the summer show train back through time and memory to the year that you lived yesterday. Tonight's destination, 1925. America. Al Smith was governor of New York. The Prince of Wales was 31 and the most eligible bachelor in the world. Jack Dempsey got married. And Babe Ruth got hurt. And Mary Pickford almost got kidnapped.
Charles Chaplin was working on his great movie, The Gold Rush. And Harold Lloyd was the delight of the nation. And on Broadway on September 21st, Dennis King appeared as François Villon and made theatrical history singing the magnificent Rudolph Trimble score of The Vagabond King.
Come on, you beggars of Paris town, you lousy rabble of low degree.
You rabble of low degree.
King Louis to keep his crown and save our city from Burgundy.
Our city from Burgundy.
You and I are good for nothing but to die. We can die for liberty. Sons of toil and danger, will you serve a stranger and bow down to sorrow, will you cheer tomorrow for the crown of Burgundy? Onward, onward, swords against the foe. Forward, forward, the lily banners go. Sons of France around us, break the chain that bound us down, down, down with Burgundy.
Sons of toil and danger, will you serve a stranger and bow down to Burgundy? Sons of shame and sorrow, will you fear tomorrow for the crown of Burgundy?
Forward, 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 our lily banners go.
It is June 15th, 1925. You're standing on the beach at Sandy Hook. You and the people around you are staring across the water. 21 miles across that water is the New York district known as the Battery. Over 7 hours ago, a 17-year-old girl plunged into the water below the Battery and started swimming toward Sandy Hook.
Here she comes!
Slowly, steadily, the girl swims towards the shore. The usual boat moves watchfully beside her. Now the sand is solid beneath her feet. Now she stands and splashes out of the water towards the excited spectators.
What was your time?
7 hours, 11 minutes, and 30 seconds.
Then she's broken the record. I'll see you later, Mike. I gotta make my deadline. Gertrude Ederle's gonna be on the front page of the afternoon edition.
Yes, in 1925, Gertrude Ederle swam from the Battery to the front pages of the world.
And in 1925, the most perfect boy and girl in America were fixed at the Chicago International Livestock Exhibition. The girl was 15 years old, 5 feet 5, and weighed 131 pounds. The boy was 14 years old, 5 feet 7, and weighed 155 pounds.
You read about it and said, wait to be healthy, but you went right on diving.
That was because a lady wasn't a lady unless she had a voice, did you?
You tried to be up-to-date and modern, and you frowned on sentiment. The sounds you hear now are the death cries of an entire era. You're sitting in a building in New York City at Fifth Avenue and 44th Street in the company of 50 men. A short distance away, men are at work tearing down the very building in which you are sitting. The moment is a solemn one. It will be remembered by everyone present.
Gentlemen, this is the last time we shall meet within these walls. For 100 years, the great men of the nation have died here. The greatest beauties of each generation have entered these doors. With its passing, one of New York's great symbols and landmarks is gone. Gentlemen, will you join me in a last toast to Delmonico?
Yes, in 1925, Delmonico's was torn down. And the papers announced that a 30-story office building would be built where it had stood.
On January 5th, 1925, the first woman governor of the state was inaugurated, Mrs. Nellie T. Ross of Wyoming. And on January 20th, the second woman governor, Mrs. Miriam Ferguson, was inaugurated in Texas.
Single hair was the vogue. The flapper was the girl of the hour. And your favorite dance, the Charleston. Good. Folks had plenty to sing about, and they had plenty of good songs to sing, too. Vincent Humans was one of our top composers, and the score for his newest musical, Known on a Net, America found a very tasty, tuneful dish of tea.
Take you upon my knee, just before two. Two for tea, me for you, and you for me. Oh,
nobody near to see us but here. No friends or students on weekend vacation. We won't have it known here that we ought to tell a tale.
me to take for all the boys to see.
Inaugurated President of the United States, and Charles G. Dawes, King Tut's tomb was opened in Egypt, and there was a shocking development in Ireland.
Well, now I must say this is the most embarrassing matter that's ever come to my attention. Where did you find that snake?
I found him in Dublin.
I wish to close your eyes and look the other way. There hasn't been a snake seen in Ireland since St. Patrick got rid of them centuries ago.
Maybe this one was for the leftover.
We'd better turn him over to the National Museum. I know they'll want to put him on exhibit. But think we should discover a snake in Ireland after all these years.
Yes, the Irish discovered a snake in their midst and promptly put him on exhibit. Oh, there was a lot of things that made headlines that year. Hindenburg was elected president of Germany. There was a land boom in Florida. And two promising young lads named Rogers and Hart wrote the score for their first full-fledged musical comedy, Dearest Enemy. And everyone began humming a great hit song.
It's all of you. it's deplorable that you were never there when little lips are so kissable.
Sentiments back in 1925, but still the sentimental songs were your biggest favorite.
Just a cottage small by a waterfall at the closing of the day.
You listen to songs like Just a Cottage Small on the new all-electric radio set, which you thought were the cat whiskers after those crystal sets with headphones.
Red Grange from Illinois was the big name in sports, and Lieutenant Commander Richard E. Byrd was one of the big names in progress. New Yorkers saw Governor Al Smith. 80,000 boys marched in the Boys Week Loyalty Day Parade. ...1925 was the year of the great earthquake in Japan. And the year of the great cyclone in the Middle West.
And it was the summer that things got so hot in Washington, they decided to see if they could fry an egg at the corner of 14th and Pennsylvania Avenue. They could, and they did. The egg fried in exactly 9 minutes.
Things moved at a merry clip in the middle of the roaring 20s. Janet Gaynor moved from Hollywood right into the heart of America. And the heart of New York was at the feet of blonde, blue-eyed Marilyn Miller, who opened in September of 1925 in Jerome Kern's great musical Sonny, singing one of the great hits of all time.
Day. Dreams I know can never be true. Seems as though I'll ever be blue. Means my happiness. Would I answer yes to? Well, you ought to guess who knows but you. Well, you ought to guess who. No one but you. No one but you.
Twenty-five years back into time and memory. Clarence Darrow's year. Secretary of State Kellogg's year. The year the cable was opened between the United States and Spain, when President Coolidge sent greetings to King Alfonso.
The year of the flasher and the chief, of short skirts and helmet hats. The year John Gilbert and Renee Adderley appeared in the movie The Big Parade and Lady Murray filmed The Merry Widow.
25 years back to those days of the Roaring Twenties. The laughter, the headlines, the hours so good to live, so good to look back on. And in 1925, The Student Prince was one of the great hits of Broadway. And The Serenade was well on its way to becoming immortal.
Song of a bird, feeling
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for joining us. In just a moment, I'll tell you what we have in store for you next week. The summer show train is written by Gene Holloway and brought to you each week this time by the American Railroads. The same railroads that will carry most of the nation's Boy Scouts to the National Jamboree at Valley Forge this week. It seems many years ago, but I still recall my scouting days with a great deal of pleasure. The days packed with adventure, travel, and fun. And this week, 47,000 lads from all over the country will take part in the colorful, exciting program to commemorate the 40th anniversary of scouting in America. About 8 out of 10 will travel by rail. Their parents share their enthusiasm for this trip, secure in the knowledge that the railroads will transport their sons safely and comfortably to and from their homes. The American Railroads extend congratulations to the Boy Scouts of America and wish them every success on the eve of this, their 40th anniversary. Jim Cohan, the Yankee Doodle Boy, was a sensation back in the early 1900s, and so it's fitting that the summer show train should take you on a special 4th of July trip to the early 1900s to relive some of their interesting happenings and hear many of the greatest songs of that period, like Yankee Doodle Boy, Mighty Like a Rose, and Ida. So folks, join us again next Monday and ride with us aboard the summer show train back to the 1900s. If you enjoyed hearing the song of the Vagabonds, friends, on tonight's program, Lucille and I would like to remind you that we've recorded the entire score of both The Vagabond King and The New Moon on Capitol Records in all three playing speeds. So now you can hear two of the operators you enjoy on the Railroad Hour anytime in these new Capitol albums. Well, it looks as though we're ready to pull out. So until next week, goodbye.
Gordon McRae is currently starring in the Warner Brothers Technicolor Western, The Return of the Frontiersman. Now for Lucille Norman, Carmen Dragon and the orchestra, the Norman Lubov Choir, and our star, Gordon McRae. This is Marv Miller with a hearty invitation from the American Railroad to join us again next week and ride the summer show train back to the early 1900s. And now stay tuned to your Monday night of music on NBC.